with GPS tracking, outdoor sports such as football, soccer and rugby use GPS during training and matches. Unfortunately, we're unable to use GPS indoors as we can't get satellite reception. However, CSIRO and the AIS have developed this system called RF tracking, radio frequency tracking. We're able to get measures or data measures that are similar from GPS. So this is one of our base stations. There are 12 located around the court and they transmit the information from the tags that the girls are wearing into my laptop. This is the tag that the athletes are wearing. Laura is taping one on Kalia now. And these transmit the information on the girls' distance, high intensity running, velocity and accelerations. So this is the data that's being fed live into my laptop. And here we can see where the girls are on court and get real-time information on their distance, high-intensity running, accelerations, and velocity.
It's our first actually comprehensive look at our training loads and the work that we're doing out on court, and this technology enables us to do it far more efficiently and effectively than we've ever done it in the past. So it's a real marrying together of high-performance sport, but also high-performance cutting-edge science.
Yeah, it's really in its infancy at the moment, but what we have found is that we can really track how much court, you know, how much movement they're making, so how far they're running, how fast they're going, so that we can then actually ensure that our trainings are meeting the needs and requirements of the athletes. But the other unique thing is we can actually have a bird's eye view of the court and actually see the athletes moving around. So for instance, we can put a little circle around my opponent and I can ensure that I'm within 2 or 3 metres of them all of the time. So that can be going around, or we can see patterns of play. So although it's, you know, really good for mapping from a workload point of view, it will be very useful tactically as well.
It's been really interesting. It's the first time I've used the technology, but it's been really cool to see the distances I'm playing in a game, my acceleration, all that kind of information that I have never had access to. And it's interesting to see and compare between games and different teams that we play, saying I've ran 3 kilometres in this game compared to 2 kilometres and different positions, and yeah, it's been really interesting.
Oh look, it's just amazing. Everything's at our fingertips here, and we've got people who are specifically looking at our area, our sport, netball, and really tracking that specifically. We don't get that enough, and we really need to do that and address that, and we need to have much more science and technology involved in our high performance sport.
I anticipate that this data will help the World Youth Cup squad in their preparation for competition in Glasgow this year, and then Netball Diamonds for their upcoming test matches, and also the Commonwealth Games squad next year. So hopefully it does have quite a good outcome across that cross-sectional group of netballers.